Hey everybody, it's Abby, and this is going to be my January favorites, and it's the first favorites I've ever done, so I'm so excited because it's the first month of the year, and it's my first favorites video, so it should be amazing, and I'm so excited to share it with you guys. Okay, so first, what should I do? Beauty products. My first favorite is an eye product, and it is the most incredible investment you could ever make for your eyes. Okay, maybe not, but it's wonderful, and that is one of these. It is a white eyeliner pencil, and I know that it kind of sounds weird, but it's not. I don't use it for like lining my eyes, because obviously that would be pointless, but it's really good for highlights, like putting it in the corners of your eyes. Or what I really love to do with these eyeliner pencils is to put it right under my brow and rub it in, and it makes for a great highlight. You guys have probably heard of the highlight under your brow, but this works much better than putting like eyeshadow under it, because eyeshadow can sometimes be like glittery or it's dusty and it just goes off and it doesn't last as long. So this is a really good option if you want a good highlight, so definitely recommend that. And my next favorite is also a makeup product. This is a face product, and it is the airbrush spray makeup by Sally Hansen. If you guys have ever watched What Not to Wear, Carmody, this is her stuff that she always uses. And it's really cool, and I got it over the summer, I think, and I was just really excited about getting it because I was like, oh, I've seen her use it, that's so cool, it looks so nice, and oh, I just really want that, I want that airbrush look. And I don't think that it gives you an airbrush look, but I don't know, it's a really good cover up for like redness. It's not so much one if you have like really dark spots, but just redness in general. Like, I have a lot of redness, my skin isn't all like perfectly one color or anything, so this really helps with that. I love this, but it's not like it could be your main foundation, or I guess it's not foundation, concealer. You definitely have to put like some powder over it or something just to kind of even it out. And for those spots that are like a little bit darker, something you actually need to put a little bit more than just like covering it up. Yes. And okay, my next favorite beauty product is a hair product, and that is this Moroccan argan oil. Yeah, okay. So this stuff, you put it in your hair after you take a shower, and it just keeps your hair looking really healthy and shiny. It also helps if you don't use a lot of heat on it, but it's just, it's wonderful. It has made my hair look so much healthier than it used to be. It used to look just dry and damaged and stuff. But that is a wonderful product, and I definitely recommend it, especially if you're trying to like wean yourself off of heat products and make your hair healthier again. And yeah, la la la. Okay, next thing is not really a beauty product. Kind of is, I guess. Okay. It's these OcuSoft eye wipes, and they are meant for like cleaning your eyes so your eye doesn't get damaged and stuff, but they are a really good makeup remover. So it's not something that you would probably have to do like just everyday makeup. You can usually just use soap and water, but this can get off like darker makeup. It'll take it right off. You don't even have to like spend time on it. It just wipes right off. So it's perfect, and I love it. So definitely recommend that if you're having some trouble getting your eyeshadow off, or also if your eyes just need it. I don't know. One thing that I didn't bring out that I would like to say is I would recommend, for those of you who wear contacts, to get the one-a-day contacts. I just got those this month, and they are amazing, and so much better than the two-week ones, so definitely recommend those. And I think that's it for beauty products, so clothing item. my favorite winter shirt, or sweater, I guess. This is really silly. Something that my sister got me for Christmas, and I think it is adorable. So, there you go. I think that is so cute, and it's so fun and wintry, and just wonderful. So, thank you, Clara, for giving me that. And yes, that is my favorite January sweater. So, yes. Let's see. Favorite. Oh, here's something that I forgot that's kind of beauty related. A very good moisturizer. Cephalo, I think. Is that what it says? Cetaphil, not Cephalo. So yeah, I have really dry skin, and this is amazing. It's amazing, because especially in the winter when your skin gets like super dry, this has been helping me out a lot. Probably the best moisturizer I've ever used, and it's even better than the one that my dermatologist recommended. So definitely if you have really dry skin, I would say check that out. And oh, favorite book of the month. I'm not done, I'm about halfway through, and it's not like it's relevant to January 2012 or even 2011 or anything like that. It's a very old book published in like the 50s, I think. 45. So it's really old, and it's really good, and I would definitely recommend it. So that is Catcher in the Rye. It's so good. And yeah, it has some language in it, so I would be careful about that. You just have to kind of judge yourself on how you can respond to that type of stuff. But it's so good. It's a lot like Looking for Alaska or Perks of Being a Wallflower, but it's just an older version of those. So I definitely recommend that. So good. And those other two books that I mentioned. And yeah, I'm trying to think. Favorite song would be Nervous Take Motion of the Head to the Left by Andrew Young or Andrew Bird or something. I don't know. I'll link it down below. I don't know why I can't think of his name right now. But it's such a good song, and I know the title sounds weird, but it is really good, so definitely check that out. And I'm trying to think what I've forgotten. Favorite movie. I did not bring that over here, but I can definitely talk about it. Favorite movie of the month and the year and my lifetime, definitely 500 Days of Summer. Yeah, it's sitting over there. I could go get it, but I'm not going to. But it's so good, and if you haven't seen it, I don't know why you haven't seen it, and I don't know why you're watching my video, because you should just go watch it. So yeah, that's what I think about that. It's perfect. Yeah. And what else? Well, I think that is it for my favorites, but I am going to talk a little bit more. So please keep listening, and thank you so much for dealing with all this. I'm definitely excited about some new videos that are going to be coming up. Hopefully some that will come up this weekend. One that I'm hoping to make is how to do your own eyebrows without going and getting them waxed or anything that takes a lot of money that you have to keep getting over and over again. So definitely look forward to that. And what was my other one? How to do a braided headband. If you want to see either of those, please leave a comment, let me know. I'll probably make them anyway, even if you don't leave a comment. But yeah, definitely let me know, and please subscribe if you enjoy, and thanks so much for watching. Check out some videos. I uploaded one last weekend on an Emma Watson eye makeup tutorial, and I would love it if you check that out. And let's see. I think that's it. So once again, thanks so much for watching, and I hope this didn't bore you to tears. And check out my other videos. Yeah. Thanks so much. Bye.